Hello world. Today I want to show you how I made this volumetric light and dust effect in After Effects. This is a great effect if you're making motion backgrounds, VJ loops, or you're just trying to add dimension to a shot in your music video or film. Now you'll notice what I've created here is a very dramatic, fantastical look with a shimmering light reflecting on these dust particles and glowing off the text. I'm not really going for realism here, I'm trying to go for something that's a sort of noticeable effect that we can easily loop if we want to. In our fresh comp here, I'm going to bring in my footage, which is actually a still shot. That's a really big shot, so I'm going to scale that down using Control-Shift-Alt-H. And bring it right into frame here. Okay, so this is the framing I want to work with for this shot. Now, next I'm going to add a solid layer. That's fine. I'm going to use my FX console to add fractal noise. There it is. All right, the fractal and noise type there are fine, but I'm going to add contrast to like 500 and brightness to negative 20. Kind of bring that down a little bit. And then we need to animate the evolution using the time expression. I'm going to go times 100 for this one. You can, of course, adjust this to however you need for your particular use case. Next, I'm going to add the radial fast blur. I'm going to go ahead and jack that up to 100. And I'm going to set the center point kind of up here at the top where the light's going to be streaming into my footage. I'm going to go ahead and pre-compose that. I'm going to move all attributes to new composition, and let's go ahead and name that just fractal noise. That'll work. All right, so let's set the transfer mode to add or screen. Since I'm using this black and white footage and I'm going for this little more like glowy effect, I'm going to use add in this case. Then add the curves. So we can really bring out the shadows and highlights of our fractal noise layer. And I'm gonna throw a levels on here to really mess with the gamma. There we go. And so now you can start to see how this effect is coming together. Now I'm gonna go ahead and do a quick and dirty mask on my fractal noise, and let's go ahead and feather that quite a bit. I like round numbers, so I'm going to set that to 175. And so here is a more limited version of our effect. It's looking pretty good. Now for our dust, I'm going to grab a clip from Cottonbro on pexels.com. This user puts up a lot of really excellent content for free to use in projects on Pexels, so I'd recommend following them. But you can grab this clip from there for free, which is great. So I'm going to bring that into my comp here. Now, first I'm going to set my blending mode to screen so I can go ahead and see my background footage. Then I'm going to grab the set matte effect. We're gonna set the matte to our fractal noise layer. We're gonna make sure we have effects and masks selected there. And then we're gonna set our use for matte luminance. I'm gonna add a levels effect to my dust layer so that I can enhance how much dust is showing up. And as you can see, as I bring it down here, we got more dust appearing in our shot. So if I ran preview this real quick, you can see dust stands out. Again, it's a slightly unnatural look compared to what you would expect to see, but we're going for a more fantastical animated sort of look here that I kind of like. So now you could leave this as it is, and it's already a great background. But if you want to do something with text here so that your text is reacting to this light, here's how I'm going to do that. First, add your text layer. We're just going to say volumetric light. All right. Now we're going to have to bring that down below our fractal noise layer. Now, one of the first things I always do when I'm doing text is I add just a very quick fast box blur. And I don't know, we'll try 0.4. Maybe we really just want to take the very edge off, maybe even less, 0.2, something stupid like that. Just to give it just a little bit less of a digital edge, if I can get my, there it is. So even that's a bit much. So let's do 0.1 with like one iteration. And go back to 0.2. There we go. Now I'm going to try to grab color from the midtones of my footage for my text color. Let's go right there. That'll work. So that the text without any light glowing on it is just sort of like average, aggressively average, right? Now I want to go ahead and do my drop shadow layer. So what I'm going to do now, instead of just adding a drop shadow, I'm going to select from my shadows, and then I'm going to move this layer down. Look at that. There it is. I'm going to change that fast box blur up to, let's say, 4, maybe more, maybe 6. Yeah, there we go. And then what I want to do now is add the corner pin effect. And I'm just going to sort of warp my text to match how my background works. This doesn't work for every scenario, but when I've got this like sort of curved background, I want my text to feel like it's hitting that curve. So something like that. That'll work. Again, we're not going for super realism here, just trying to sort of highlight the effect we're creating here. All right, now I'm going to create a layer that is the reactive glow layer of my text. All right, so on text layer 3, you can do this with the built-in glow in After Effects, but I'm going to be using the deep glow from AE Scripts because I find it's just easier to work with and get a better look. Let's set the track mat to this layer of the luma of our fractal noise. And then we got to turn our fractal noise back on, which is always annoying. And then you can mess around with your glow radius. Your exposure. I'm going to set this to 0.75 with a glow radius of 800. And so now if we play this back, you can see how it's interacting with our text now. So that's really bright. So I'm actually going to adjust my S curves, make a few other adjustments. There we go. Something like that. All right. Now, if we add a adjustment layer here, I'm just going to call this FX. I'm going to throw on a noise HLS effect. Bring up the lightness to, I don't know, 15. That's a lot. So maybe about 8. So we get some noise and grain going on in here. I'm going to change that from uniform to grain. Maybe grow the grain size to about 2 for a really kind of grungy look there. And now if we mess with our transfer mode, like if we set it to overlay or, I don't know, soft light, we can get slightly different looks here than just the normal. So I'm going to leave it in overlay mode. Really heightens the effect that I've got going on here. And well, there you have it, a volumetric light effect complete with dust and glowing text that's all procedural and interactive with the effect that you've created. It's pretty simple, and this is a really easy effect to replicate for all kinds of footage just using the fast radial blur. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment if there's anything you think I missed, or if you have any other questions you'd like for me to answer about this or other kinds of effects in After Effects. If you want to see more of my work in progress, different things I'm working on, you can head over to Instagram. I'm at Tregde Media. And if you want a head start on your motion graphics projects, head over to my online store where I have free and premium stock assets and presets to help you make some awesome stuff just like this. Thanks, and I'll catch you in the next one.